Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to round number 6 here of the chase for the Universal Orlando Cup Series Season 4 Championship. And boy, I will tell you something. This has been an unbelievable chase. Very spread out, though, to very surprising. But nonetheless, though, it ain't over yet till it's over, is what they say. I'll tell you one thing, though. Chris Washer and Levi McIntyre have been enjoying the chase so far, but for others, they really need these good runs, especially if you're James Qualls, Kyle Keefe, Johnny Gardner, and others towards the bottom of the field. It's do or die mode from now on. After this will be a total of 4 more races, so we crown ourselves our champion for Season 4. But nonetheless, here comes our lineup. Jordan Davis on the pole. Second is Kyle Miller. Third is Marco Martinez. Miller, the highest ranked chaser. Fourth, Keith Batson. Fifth, Dylan Pote. Sixth, Alex May. Seventh, Johnny Gardner. Eighth, Charles Sanford. Ninth, Tanner Sullivan. Completing the top 10 is Nathan Hudson. As here's the rest of your starting lineup here at M&M's. Chris Washer, Levi McIntyre starting on the outside line for today's race. And on the front row, we have Jonathan Zorlin and Jessica Shelton. Jordan Davis, Kyle Miller on the front row for today's race. Now this track, I don't know if I mentioned the Outback race, is very similar to Coca-Cola, except it is repaved, M&M's theming, and it goes on from there. So points coming in, Chris Washer's got a 5-point lead over Levi McIntyre, and then McIntyre is separated from, I believe there is a 5,045, yep, there's a 4-way tie for third place, and that includes Tanner Sullivan, as they gave the command. Tanner Sullivan, JT Bryant, Michael Walton, and Charles Sanford all have 5,045 points, and then Jessica Shelton's next with 5,043, and then Trent Dunham with 5,040, and then the rest are 5,030 or 5,020. These drivers, they need to make sure that 35 and 19 get in trouble. Otherwise, it's not going to help them out one bit. And see all 42 drivers go on by. There you see all 42 drivers in the field here trying to do whatever they can. Have a good chase. As Jordan Davis, Kyle Miller are going to be leading them down here for the second half of the chase. And here we go. Green flag is out. We are underway here at M&M's. This is big for Johnny Gardner, Marco Martinez, and Tanner Sullivan are starting the inside line. They're probably going to get the positions. As you're going to see a lot of spread out racing. 2-3 wide, possibly 4. You go 5 wide, and that will not be good. Johnny Gardner wasting no time whatsoever. He wants to get up to the front, as to a Trent Dunham. In the meantime, Jordan Davis, Marco Martinez, your front row for today's race. As Martinez is now going to go for the lead. Look at the racing they're at right now. 4 wide. Is confirmed a good style of racing here. However, if they go 5 wide and beyond, that is not the best idea. And leading lap number 1 is going to be the 11 of Marco Martinez. However, that's not going to last long. Oh my god, that's 5 wide there. That is not good. Right in front of Kyle Miller, the outside pole, or the outside, outside pole sitter there. At the racing we got here. 4 wide for the lead here. Stephen Pollard the third, the Jetta. And James Qualls making an appearance up in the front of the field. This is what the 20 car needs. He almost turned Benjamin Miles right there. That was close. Kyle Keefe just went out of line right there. He's in the grass. And he's going to keep together. As leading that lap was Pollard. No, they said Benjamin Miles just led that lap. I thought the 06 had it, but the 33 just edged him out there. Oh, Michael Walton, a very bad pickle. He's going to wisely get out of that situation. looking through the middle of the pack, you could just see these drivers already trying to make no time ever, you know, trying to get up to the front. Chris Washer, he's trying to make early work going to the inside line. It's the Dolan BMW. Oh, no, 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 no. Kyle Matthews, PJ Williams. Oh, hold your breath, Luvier. Joshua Falcon. Hard into the inside wall. Going down pit road, Luvier and Joshua Falcon. Falcon's out of it. I think Luvier's going to have to serve a penalty while he's on pit road. In the meantime, they are going to make a pit stop with the Doge going forward. Oh, and Seth Cole just got dubbed hard with Levi McIntyre, second in the points. And McIntyre smoking. He's done. No caution there. Still remain green. That's what Chris Washer needed to see. That's what other chasers need to see. But now they need the 35 to get involved. As there's heavy smoke from the earlier incident there. Now the caution's out. Sullivan just, I think, led them down. He barely did. Oh, PJ Williams just brake checked in front of Chris Washer. That was close. I think they had to pull the caution because of the 19 leaking fluid. Look at the skid marks coming down pit road right there. That was from the 91 and 98. And Levi McIntyre to Stanley. Toyota Camry going to be done for an early exit there. That is not what he needed. You can see skid marks there from all the wrecking taking place there. Chris Luvier, car number 98, trying to get up to the front, get his lap back. McIntyre with a piston issue. Now Luvier be on the tail end lead lap. He'll be good to go on the pit stops here. What a mess. An all-star with Joshua Balkan and Chris Luvier coming off turn four. And then Seth Cole, Levi McIntyre. That is not what Levi had in mind. Tanner Sullivan, though, up in front. I think they're coming down pit road. Chris Washer's coming down. There's a mix of cars coming down pit road. But leading them down will be the Dawn BMW of Chris Washer. As we're going to see it from the TV2, or pit lane 2 camera angle, rather, excuse me. Chris Washer, Clint Spillman, second all-time on all-time wins here. Oh, Michael Norman had trouble trying to get in the pit road. He got into Clint Spillman there. Angel Navarro also has some left side damage as the Z-Lib Toyota. Jackie Tang coming on out. And Kyle Miller coming on out. Now Navarro gets out of pit road as well. Tanner Sullivan, the leader. Let's look at what happened with both incidents. Well, here's the look at what did not bring out the caution. Joshua Balkan, Chris Luvier. Yeah, these guys were running extremely tight right here. And it was only going to be a matter of time. And right there, Luvier just kind of runs up the track. Balkan bounced off Lamas just a bit. And then both made contact. They looked like they were going to be okay, but then Balkan kind of pushes Luvier down. And both of these guys, they take a hard hit. Balkan especially, wow, he took a shot to the wall. Chris Luvier actually bounced off the 91. It really didn't get any damage because of that. He only just had left side damage, and they repaired it up with little to no problem. Look at Luvier, too. He spun around two times, and he managed to fire that car back up and have no problem at all. So nice job by the Doge going forward there. But Joshua Balkan, already an early exit for the Mountain Dew Code Red Ford, who's already leaving at the end of the season, S2 with the 98. Let's look what happened to those guys. Now we got to jump up to Seth Cole, Levi McIntyre. That is okay. We're going to have to go with this route right here. May as well keep it on the same clip. Alright, let's see. We're going to slow down once they exit turn two. These guys were really... just the same thing happened with Balkan and Luvia. They were just too tight coming into the corner panel. Seth Cole actually bounces off Jordan Davis right there. Seth just goes nowhere to go but to Levi McIntyre. Watch the hit. Wow. Both take hard shots to the inside wall right there. does the Hershey Chevrolet and the Stanley Tools Toyota Camry there. As Seth Cole's car comes to a dead stop, Levi McIntyre, he's smoking, coming on down the pit road, and that's what brought herself our first caution for today's race here at Mims. The race starts, give us one left to go. Drivers out of the race include Joshua Balkan, Seth Cole, and Levi McIntyre, which has got to be a big blow right there for the 19. He's got to hope the 35 encounters a big, big problem in that BMW. Otherwise, Washer's going to run away with it. Speaking of Washer, he is 30th right now on the track. Some cars have pitted, some did not. Tanner Sullivan is your leader. P.J. Williams, second. Kyle Matthews, third. Jonathan Zerlin, fourth. James Falls, fifth. Kyle Keith, sixth. Steve Butler, third. Seventh. Kenny Ritchie, eighth. Kyle Sosnowski, ninth. Hey, completing the top 10, Sky Commons. As the green flag is back underway here at M&M's. Some guys who are not doing well in the chase, like Qualls, Keith, and Pollard, the third, up in the front of the field. For those drivers. Find our other chasers here. Michael Walton, 15th. Charles Sanford, 16th. Have to keep an eye on that right there. Marco Martinez, 25th. Jessica Shelton, 26th. Johnny Gardner, 27th, at least in the battle for that spot. J.T. Bryant, 29th. And there's Washer, 30th. Only other chaser pitted with 35 was the 43. Funny enough, Chris Louvier, still up the speed there, is the number 98. Following the 25 around as best he can. Well, then again, he is losing it. Doge going forward off the pace. That's 4 or 5 wide for the lead right there. These guys are really making wide racing. Tanner Sullivan nearly turned the 88 right there, and he slides down. Good move by the two. Jordan Davis, your pole sitter, trying to retake the lead. We haven't seen in a while that the front row encountered problems before on the very first caution. That's the first time ever we've ever seen that in the NRSL. M&M's, Jordan Davis, and Kyle Miller, no problems whatsoever so far. They're doing good. But Anthony Ritchie, our winner at Thornton, out in front, and he is going to lead this lap right here. As they are 4 wide for second. Now 5. Oh, that's a little too tight. Especially with teammates Dylan Poteen need it done. They're going to move out of the way there. And at least give each other room. Someone is really going to choke here. And you could tell that 98 is off the pace a bit. Michael Norman a little bit off the pace. I think he messed up there. He doesn't have damage. Angel Navarro could spill them. They're just a tad off the pace. But they'll probably catch up to Kyle Matthews if they stayed in their pace there. Oh, there's a crash on turn 4! It's Tanner Sullivan in the 2! Oh my god, Martinez hard into the wall! Michael Norman just got damaged! Oh my god, the 11 of Martinez into the pit wall! And Chris Washer made it by again! There's another chaser! And that is not what Levi McIntyre wanted to see, was other chasers get involved. Especially Sullivan and Martinez, who took a shot into that pit road wall. We're going to take a quick break here and take a look what happened. Boy, this was a mess. Take a look at this here. You got Chaser Tarrant Sullivan right in the mix. Johnny Gardner right there. All right there, Gardner, Nathan Hudson, Mark Martinez, Jonathan Zorlin, and Tanner Sullivan all get involved right there. Now we're going to show you this part of the wreck. Ah, Cody, there's where he gets involved, right nearly in the Chris Washer, but he makes it by. Caleb Harris, he gets a tiny piece of it. I don't think that's really going to affect him, but Kyle Keith's going to barely get by there. Right in front of Pollard, the third in the 06. Michael Norman just slowed up and just got a tiny piece of that incident right there. Now we have to go back and see this guy, Marco Martinez. His wild ride, including hitting the pit wall. I don't know what he was thinking there at that time, but I don't know what to say. Take a look where he was at that moment now. Remember that Johnny Gardner got a Cavagnaro from that point? Cavagnaro got a little too tight off the corner to watch. know, there's the contact there. Now, watch Martinez, Hudson, and JT Bryant. But mainly these two. Now, these guys managed to save it. There's JT. He slid his card. I don't know how he kept that off the pit road wall, but I guess Martinez was deciding to come back up the track, but he should have came down pit road, couldn't steer enough to go right head on into the pit wall. Oh, that is a terrible impact right there for the FedEx Express Toyota. Going from a winner at the Brickyard to top chaser in race number 3, I believe it was, or it was race 2, to crashing hard at M&M in the pit road wall going at least 230. Vicious impact. Lucky enough, Martinez is okay. He's out of the race, though. Let's take you back to live action. Well, there's a weird separation from 5th and 6th place, but there are drivers coming down pit road. Dutta is going to stay out, and I believe he was one of the drivers who did come to pit road first time by. Here comes the rest of the pack. Makes the powers all stand out as... Oh, Michael Wald got to Jessica Shelton! And car 99 with trouble, as well with the 0-2. Oh my god, Michael Walton, another chaser involved with damage. That is going to really hurt the Subway Avocado Ford Fusion there. He's going to come back up the track, though. Chris Washer, JT Bryant also down, probably the third and others. Ooh, Walton, you better get out of that situation. And he looks like he will be. So he's going to be off the pace. There goes another chaser. These are all the cards that stayed out. Ian Dutta, Mason Powers, Cody Blomas, Kyle Matthews, Kyle Keith, Power Quest, PJ Williams, Guy Commons, Tanner Sullivan. They all stayed out. And then there is Trent Dunn, the first one off pit road. He beat Anthony Ritchie. Now because of Michael Walton, I'm here to see how the other drivers are going to be off the pace. Jessica Shelton in the 0-2. Where'd she go? There she is. I didn't see her there, so... Now, she's got rear-end damage, but I don't think she's going to be off the pace, because it's rear-end damage, so... We'll see what happens, though, nonetheless. Ian Dutta, currently the leader. Let's take it back to live action as we're at the halfway point for the green flag. Well, after that, Marco Martinez is the only one who retired out of the race from that incident there. Michael Walton, who had that damage earlier, had to come back down pit road, remove the hood from the car, and replace whatever damage possible to that 99 car. He's back out on the track in his 38th position, still on the lead lap. Ian Dutta, currently the leader, second Mason Powers, now the all-time winningest driver after his win at Michigan. Third, Cody Lamas, fourth, Kyle Matthews, fifth, Kyle Keefe, sixth, Power Quest, seventh, PJ Williams, eighth, Sky Commons, ninth, Tanner Sullivan, clean the top 10 is Trent Dunham, 11th through 20th, Anthony Ritchie, Benjamin Miles, Keith Batson, Dylan Pote, Charles Sanford, Jessica Shelton, Austin Mungold, William Duncan, Anthony Curry, and Jordan Davis. Chris Washer is in 21st. Rest of the chasers that are there, James Qualls, 25th. Kyle Miller, 29th. Stephen Pollard, 33rd. JT Bryant, 34th. Johnny Gardner, 35th. And Michael Walton, in 38th. He's got to be frustrated after that incident there. As green flag is back underway here at M&M Super Speedway, Dutta and Powers got to a good start. Cody kind of spun the tires a bit there. All eyes are going to be on car 35 to see how many points he can really gain off the 19. I remember Qualls is behind the 35, and Michael Norman, I don't know why he is slow. He may be down a cylinder because, well, he does have a little bit of damage, but it really is not shown on the two Chevrolet. Let's look on board. And not really shown. Tanner Sullivan. Oh yeah, he's off the pace. Oh god, this is cancerous looking. Kyle Miller going to get by. James Qualls going to get by. And they're really getting held up by the two. There's another chaser with problems. This is big for the 35 car. Ooh, Louvier. And drivers coming down pit road. That is Powers and Caleb Paris. Those two stayed out. And because of that, they're in trouble. West and Dutta have ran away. Then Williams and Matthews, and there's the rest of the pack. Washer just continuing to waste no time passing whatever car he can and trying to get up to the front. Trying to be the first ever two-time champion in the Cup Series. Now the guys are going to be on the rest of the drivers to stay out, including the 95, the 32, the 14, and the 88. I believe those are the only drivers who stayed out, as well as the two of Sullivan, I believe. Yeah, he stayed out. And indeed, they come on down. Oh, Lama, Smongold, Trent Dunham, Matthews. Yep, they're all down. Oh, wow, they're really bunched up here. Nonetheless, though, we go back up to the front of the field. As it is Dylan Potee out in front, trying to catch up to Caleb Harris and Mason Powers in the 18 and 41. Now P.J. Williams, Charles Samford, others trying to do whatever they can to pass 31. Samford is currently the highest running chaser in the Mitsubishi Lancer. Samford did announce he's going to be teaming up with Jessica Sheldon at the end of this, next season. And we switch it over to a Chevrolet. Oh, P.J.'s on down. I guess they are doing green flag pit stops. I don't know why they are doing that. I guess the tire wear really must be hurting them after all the recent crashes that have been happening. They may have picked up some debris there. Oh, Pollard the third nearly got turned by Alex May there. Close call there. Charles Samper out in front. However, Batson, Jordan Davis, and here comes Washer and Miller all coming to the fray. James Qualls making a stride up there as well. He can get around the 35 and finish ahead of him. He'll be a really good point save for him. These drivers still continue to stay out, though, nonetheless, as this time by, it'll be 7 to go. Davis leading that lap. Racing is getting really intense. Angel Navarro, 3 wide for the lead. Oh my, there is a lot of lap cars there. Comes Hudson and Navarro. The wall. I thought somebody hit the wall. I guess not. Second, that's Alex May, Dylan Potee, Kyle Sosnowski, and May's going to get it. Ooh, that was close. Here we go, 5 to go. Hudson, Alex May, battling for that lead there, catching up to Trent Dunham and trying to do whatever they can to put him back down. Oh god, 5 wide. That's for, I believe, the 5th position. They're going to settle it out for now. Are these guys from this pack going to pit? And if so, who's going to be coming on down? Kurt Washer's got to be in a really good position right now. Not only is he passing chasers, but he's just trying to get every point possible to get ahead of McIntyre to try to get the championship easy way. Don BMW just going out on a strong note. Ooh, that was close. That was close. Samper, Miller, and McCurry, all contact. They keep it together. Batson was the one who led that lap. Here comes Tang. Here comes Pollard the third. There comes Miller. He's ahead of the 35. This is big. Big, 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 big. Now Qualls will get ahead of him. Charles Samford trying to be the next one to get around him. In the 0-3. That's two for Gardner and for Shelton. All the chasers, in fact, are trying to get around that 35 car. 3 to go next time by... Oh, in trouble! Chris Washer's around! Chris Washer, it's Crash, Spillman, and this is for the win! Miller at the line! Kyle Miller just edged out McCurry and Qualls, and a caution coming out involving the Dawn BMW. However, he is not on pit road. I seen Shelton did go down, though. Poti is down as well. Sosnowski, heavily damaged. Spillman, heavily damaged. That is going to be the race right there. I'm trying to see. Washer was scored 18th, but finished ahead of Gardner and Shelton. But Kyle Miller is going to get 16 big points. He's a driver that was desperate to win. Really needed it badly. Looking at the points that he had, he was 9 points behind the four-way tie right there. He was at least 31 points behind. So this is going to be big for Kyle Miller there. And the monster forward. Anyone coming up hit road? Quint Spillman's coming down. There's down. Where the 35 is. Oh, and he's out of gas. Oh my god, this changes everything. So now, fuel strategy coming into play. Oh my god, this changes everything. And they need to teleport him off the track ASAP. Don't Poe keep going by him there in the 31. And there it is right there. That's the big one there. Washer. What, 2 laps to go? Out of gas, and this changes everything. Levi McIntyre only had to deal with 2 people ahead of Chris Washer that were in the chase. Other than that, Washer gotta be so upset right now. As we're 2 laps to go in the race, from bad to worse is the 35 car there. The points leader, heavily trouble. Miller the leader. Let's look at what happened. I apologize for the bad commentary toward the end, a very little silent and all, but let's kind of see what happened here to Chris Washer and others. I guarantee you Levi McIntyre has got to be extremely happy about this. This is something that he really needed to see. I think Washer may have caused this accident. Then again, nope, Sosnowski goes into Poti, goes into Chris Washer. And there they go from there. Jessica Shelton gets contact. She goes down pit road. However, she keeps her car together. Spillman's going to give the blow to Washer right there. Oh, wow, look at this. Shelton got more contact right there. Just avoids in the pit wall. Kyle Sosnowski actually back into the pit wall, and Johnny Gardner gets involved right there. Lucky break for Sosnowski, almost the second driver, really pound that wall there. Now, because of that, Shelton actually did come down pit road. She was the first stall. And then she basically went in and out. But then just things went bad to worse for car number 35. As all of a sudden, watch his speed. Right there. He's trying to coast. Watch where it really goes downhill. I see he's maintaining pace speed here, which is 55. And right there, where he moves down, he just knows something was not right with the 35 BMW. This car just drops speed, and he just does not make it on pit road, teleports. A big frustrating blow to the 35 BMW. That is what Pacers really were happy to see right there. Let's take back to live action to see if Kyle Miller win today's race. Well, Kyle Miller, car number 43, When he crosses the stripe here, we'll pick up his third win of the season. And he'll be the second driver to do that this season, other than Chris Washer, who did it this season. And two other drivers did it last season. Both were in the 40 numbers. Those were Mesa Powers and Kyle Keith, who Powers won four races that season, and Kyle Keith won three. So, very interesting there to see Kyle Miller become a three-time winner in the Cup Series after a struggling two seasons he has had in the 43 car, made the chase because of his two wins, and coming off the final corner, Kyle Miller is going to do the unthinkable here, comes out of nowhere, with James Walls getting the second highest and third highest to Pollard the third. He is going to win here at M&M Super Speedway in the second half of the chase. What a job for Kyle Miller. This has got to be huge for the Ken Block Monster Car. Let's look at your top 10 rundown there. Kyle Miller was the winner for today's race. He's going to get 16 points. 13 will go to James Qualls. 12 will go to Pollard the third. 11 for Charles Samper. 10 will go to JT Bryant. 9 will go to Johnny Gardner. 8 will go to Jessica Shelton. 7 will go to Michael Walton. After everything that happened to him, he'll end up with 7 points. 6 will go to Trent Dunham. 5 will go to Kyle Keith. 4 will go to Chris Washer. Wow, that's a tough blow for him. 3 for Sullivan. 2 for Martinez. And 1 for Levi McIntyre. That was a look at everything with your finish. Well, that result here. Here, we'll show you here about the others. I just want to thank you guys for watching today's race. If you liked it, sure give it a like, comment, your thoughts, this race, subscribe, part of the internet, hit that subscribe button. See you guys later. Kyle Miller, victorious in the beginning of the second half of the chase. Till then, I will see you guys later for Kansas, which will be our last speedway race of the season and chase. Till then, hi everybody for M&M's. Congrats to Kyle Miller one last time in the victory. Till then, we'll see you at Kansas.